Hey there, don't mind me. This is all my research for my next tier list. And if you haven't already gathered, the topic is fruit. Here's my ranking so far. On the top, I've got apples, oranges. Midway features the pineapple and banana. And on the bottom, where they rightfully belong, we have rock melon and watermelon. Seriously, who even likes melons? They taste like shampoo. Don't agree? Well, tough. This is my video. Hi, I'm Charlotte from Canva Design School. If you're like me and enjoy stirring the pot or creating passionate discussions, you're going to love tier lists. Guaranteed to get people talking. First, we'll cover what to include and how to use templates. Then I'll show you different ways to share your design and kickstart some seriously fun debates. All right, let me quickly explain the purpose of a tier list in case you have been living under a rock. Tier lists are created to rank. Rank what, you ask? Well, anything really. From best to worst, or favourite to least favourite. Used by individuals, businesses, and in the classroom. To share opinions and spark some public debate. When posted on social media, friends and followers can use the comment section to scrutinise the ranking and offer their own opinion. But they can also be used in person to stimulate discussion and break the ice. Make sure you hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. That way you won't miss any of our upcoming videos. All right, let's begin. I'll type tier list in search. There are some great ones here. I'll stick with summer fruits, since I've done the research and all. Those with the crown are exclusive to Pro and Canva for team users, or Canva for education. You get all the Pro stuff as well. Perhaps this one. I'll change the background color to something light and summery. And then the text to make it visible again. Since I only want three tiers, I'll remove the rest, along with the graphics I no longer need. Tier list categories are really up to you, but typically they're A to D, and that's pretty self-explanatory. But what about the S? I've seen this appear on social media, people just responding to a post with S. Most frequently, it means super, superb, or superior. However, S rank originated from academic grading in Japan. Teachers could use a grade of S to showcase a level above A, to motivate truly exceptional academic performance. All right, let's get back into it. Instead of deleting them one by one, I can highlight the lot like this. Then hit delete on my keyboard. I'll make this one neutral and this one loathe. That looks better. Now for a different font. To change it, simply highlight the text and head over here. You can search for a particular style or scroll until you see one you like. I'll go with something simple like this. Then perhaps a fancier font for the heading. Now to add some pictures. Let's see what comes up when I search fruit in the Elements panel. To filter the results, I'll hit this button because I'm only interested in adding graphics. I really like the style of this mango, but before I add it, I want to see if there are more fruits like this to create a consistent look. I'll click these three dots, then select the option View Collection. Wow, I wasn't expecting to see this many. How good. I may as well add most of them. Now I can resize them and move each one into position. Obviously, the apple belongs up here, and the watermelon can go right down the bottom here. The banana can go here, and the blueberries, I think I'll pop them here. Actually, no, here. Almost done. What do you think? Are you nodding along in agreement right now, or shaking your head? Let me know in the comments if you agree or disagree with my ranking. Maybe we can start the debate right here, right now. Okay, let's say I want to share this on Facebook. To download it, I'll head to share and click here. Make it a PNG and hit this button. Once it's finished downloading, it'll be saved to my computer and I can upload it anytime. For Facebook business accounts or Instagram users, it's even simpler to post because you can do it directly from Canva. Just go to the share panel, click here and select your preferred platform. If you haven't used the feature before, you'll need to link your account first. But once that's done, you'll be able to post all sorts of content within seconds. All right, let's create another design for a new topic. Perhaps something I can post in the family group chat to get a reaction out of Mum. I know, I'll create a tier list for me and my sisters to use to rank our childhood dinners. I'll use this template as a starting point. First, I'll change all the text, starting with the title. I'll call it Childhood Dinners. Then I'll add a subtitle so everyone knows I'm talking about the dinners Mum cooked when we were growing up. Next, I'll switch these letters to comments we used to make as kids. I hope everyone finds it funny, including Mum. She loves a bit of friendly banter, so I'm sure she'll be fine. And finally, I'll add some frames down the bottom to hold photos. That way, they'll be the same size and shape, regardless of the original dimensions. Once I've added one, I'll duplicate it several times and line them up like this. Now I just need to find photos of all the meals Mum used to make. Instead of scouring the internet, I'll see what's available in Canva's stock library. I'll type pasta bake and click photos to filter the results. This looks similar to what I remember. To add it, I'll drag it across and hover it over the frame. Once it's in, I can crop and reposition it by heading over here. I'll repeat the process to add more photos. I can't wait to share this with my sisters and see their rankings. But first, I need to lock down the elements I don't want them to touch, which is just about everything, except for the photos and the subtitles. To lock an element, make sure it's selected, then hit this icon. Now that's done, I can hand it over. To share it as a template, I'll head up here and click this icon, then send the link in a direct message. When they open it, they'll be able to drag the photos into place to create their own ultimate tier list. Then they can share a view-only link or a PNG in the group chat for everyone to enjoy and argue over. Would your family members have fun bantering over something like this, or would it end in tears? All right, I think we have time for one more design, but it will need to be quick. This time, I want to show you how to turn a design into a printable to be used as an icebreaker or classroom activity. I can't stress enough how great tier lists are for the classroom. If you really want your students engaged and focused, this is a great way to begin a class. So I've already picked a template and added all the photos down the bottom. First, I'll delete these labels and add emojis instead. To see all the options at once, I'll go to Apps and click this emoji button. Now I can find the most suitable expressions. I'll add the heart eyes for the top tier, then this, this, and this. And finally, the spew face. I love it. All I need now are some subtle instructions. I'll start by adding some text up here and a space for a name. Then I'll make this dotted line. Can you guess why? I'll add some scissors so it's super clear. I'll have these sitting on their desk when they come in, along with some scissors and glue, so they can spend the first part of the lesson putting it all together. Then we could do it as a whole class, maybe on the whiteboard, and tally up what everyone thinks. It'd be sure to get their attention. Now, before you go, let me know in the comments what type of list you plan to make and where you might use it. Great, you're still here. Before you run off, it would be wonderful if you could like this video so others can see it. And if you've got some more time up your sleeve, why not check out these? This one's my fave. Oh, maybe I can make a tier list of the playlist videos. Anyway, see you next time.